Please welcome the senior class president, Tucker Koonsman.
Good evening. My name is Tucker Koonsman, and I am the president of the Griggsville-Perry High School class of 2020. Before I continue, I would like to say a short prayer. If you are of a praying mind, would you please bow your heads? Dear God, as we celebrate the end of another school year, we thank you for the many blessings you have given to each and every person listening tonight. Our world seems chaotic right now, but we know you are in control even though we feel so out of control. I ask that you watch over each of my classmates as they go forward into the next chapter of life. Please guide them and keep them safe. I ask all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome to the first ever Griggsville-Perry High School virtual commencement ceremony. I hope everyone listening has been safe and healthy these last few months. These past 4 years have been a wild ride for the class of 2020. If we didn't have the support system that we have had to tolerate us, I'm not sure where we would be today. From all the homecoming TP wars to making an attempt to stay off our phones, although that never worked too well, the class of 2020 would like to say thank you to the following people at GPHS for making an effort to keep us in line. Griggsville-Perry School District Board of Education, Mr. Kerfin, Mrs. Wilson, Mr. Tate, Mrs. Pearson, Mr. Dunham, Mr. DeHart, and my dad, Mr. Koonsman. Thank you for the countless and thankless hours you spend to help make this school the best it can be. Superintendent Kent Hawley and Principal Jillian Tice, thank you for keeping everyone moving in the right direction at school. Without your positive attitudes every day in the hallway and on the announcements, our school would be a boring place. Kathy and Carlene, thank you for keeping all of our paperwork in order. No one does it better than this dynamic duo. Our teachers, guidance counselors, and coaches, thank you for working with us each and every day of the school year. Your time and energy spent in the gym or on the diamond and in the classroom has not gone unnoticed. Nurse Kate, thank you for making sure we are feeling our best and are at the top of our game every day. Janitors Doug, Brian, and John, thank you for making sure the school building is safe and clean. We appreciate all you do on a daily basis to keep things looking good around the school. Cooks Jackie, Jessica, and Peggy, thank you for always having our breakfast and lunch ready so we have the energy to get through the day. Our class sponsor, Mrs. Conkright, our class has been lucky enough to have you as our class sponsor for the past 2 years. From deciding on fundraisers to planning prom to planning our senior trip to San Diego, California, which didn't happen because of COVID-19, we couldn't have asked for a better sponsor. Thank you for your help and guidance through all of it. We were ready to celebrate the end of our high school days with you in San Diego. Our parents, grandparents, siblings, friends, and community members, thank you for cheering us on, good days and bad. Your encouragement and support has helped guide us these last 4 years. Finally, to the class of 2020. Even though I didn't join this class until my sixth grade year, I want to thank you for the fun times and memories we have made during our time together at GPHS. While there have been a lot of disappointments at the end of our senior year, I'd say we have hit this one out of the park. Having a love of baseball that I do, I'd like to leave you with one final thought I think we can all relate to in these unprecedented and unpredictable times. Life is like a baseball game. When you think a fastball is coming, you got to be ready to hit the curve. Thank you.
Good evening. I am Jillian Tice, and I am the principal of Griggsville-Perry High School. I have the honor and privilege to serve this class, this school, and this community at Griggsville-Perry High School. Tonight, I welcome each of our families, friends, and guests, and thank everyone for joining us to recognize our graduating class of 2020. I would first like to thank all the parents and families for their willingness to help the school. Your active participation in your child's education is appreciated by the Griggsville-Perry faculty and staff. You have raised some excellent young men and women, and the class of 2020 will be missed. I also want to thank the teachers and staff at Griggsville-Perry High School. Each one spends many hours planning, preparing, and delivering lessons to their students. They build relationships with each student and act as the family unit, supporting the students as they progress through their high school years. Thank you for all you do. Before I speak to our graduates, I would like to recognize two students for their bravery and willingness to serve in the U.S. military. Mr. Tyler DeJanes, son of Dave and Tammy DeJanes, has enlisted in the Illinois National Guard. Tyler completed his basic training last summer and will leave in July for his AIT school. Tyler Thomas, son of Chuck and Charlotte Thomas, plans to enlist in the Illinois National Guard this summer. Tyler DeJanes and Tyler Thomas, thank you for your service. We are incredibly proud of you. To the class of 2020, your year was cut short, but there are still many memories that you will hold on to from your senior year. As the year went on, I began a list of the top 10 sayings of the class of 2020. My list was cut short due to the school closure, so I present to you the top 5 sayings from the class of 2020. Number 5, you're just like my mom, always telling me not to do stuff. Yes, I am. When you are here, I consider you part of my family. You will always be my kids. Number 4, when is graduation? Asked on the very first day of school. Number 3, are we getting out early today? Asked at the first sight of a snowflake or a gray sky. Number 2, what time are we getting out early today? Again, at the sight of the very first snowflake. And number 1, can I go home? Asked on a daily basis, and don't worry, my answer was always no. Do you see a pattern there? Little did we know this year would take a drastic turn and the lives of these students would be completely turned upside down and they would spend 2.5 months learning at home. They've gone from wanting to get out early to wanting so desperately to be back into the building with their teachers and their peers. They've sacrificed ball games, senior prom, senior trip, their graduation march through the hallways, and so many more milestones. They've handled this transition with grace. They did their work online, submitted work via email, and kept in contact with their teachers. These students didn't argue or complain. They just did what needed to be done. I think this shows a lot about these students. They are flexible and resilient. As they close this door and open a new one, I'm confident they will be successful in all they do. To the class of 2020, just know that the world is an amazing, loving, beautiful place, and it is waiting for you with open arms. We can't wait to see what you do in the future. Class of 2020, we are so proud of you. Congratulations on your graduation.
I am honored to give a second speech to the class of 2020 as salutatorian. Graduating high school is a memorable event for any high school senior. It's the ending of a chapter and the beginning of another. Whether it be college, the workforce, the military, or something else, as a class, we are thankful to GP's administration and Board of Education for giving us the opportunity to celebrate our high school graduation in some way, given the circumstances going on in our world with COVID-19. Leaving high school can be exciting and scary all at the same time. 2020 high school seniors were born into the violence of 9/11, and we are graduating into a global pandemic. To say we are a resilient group of individuals would be an understatement. As we leave something that has been so familiar to us for the past 12 years, I would like to share a few rules of life with my classmates. Rule number 1, let it go. Never ruin a good day by thinking about a bad yesterday. To move forward in life, we have to keep our eyes looking ahead of us. Let those bad days go and don't let them keep you from succeeding at whatever it is you are doing. Rule number 2, ignore them. Live a life that is empowering to you. You're the only person who can make decisions for you. Not your parents, not your boss, not your friends, and not your enemies. As you go through life, think about what makes you the best you can be and ignore them. Rule number 3, give it time. Time heals everything. It may not heal the situation as quickly as you want it to, but give it time and be patient. Rule number 4, don't compare. The only person you should try to be is the person you were yesterday. There's only one you. Don't compare yourself to your classmate or your coworker or your friend. We are each our own individual person and we are who we are. Rule number 5, stay calm. It's okay to not have everything figured out. Just know that in time you'll get there. Life is about trial and error. Enjoy the ride and see what happens. Rule number 6, it's on you. Only you are in charge of your happiness. I'm sure we've all had days where we didn't want to get out of bed. The second we open our eyes, it's our choice to decide if we are going to have a good or bad day. What will you decide? And rule number 7, don't take life for granted. Life is short. Enjoy it while you have it. We are not guaranteed tomorrow. We are not even guaranteed our next minute. Live each day to its fullest and make the most of each and every situation. It will make you a better person. In closing, the class of 2020 has learned a lot from our time at GP. as well as these unprecedented times in our world. The combination of these experiences has helped us shape into the young adults we are now, and it will be a tool we can use to continue to grow as we move on to the next phase of life. No matter what each of us ends up doing, we will have a great story to tell our children and grandchildren. I wish each of you the very best and hope you can apply these rules to your lives as we leave our high school days behind. Well done, class of 2020.
The honor of valedictorian is awarded to the graduating senior with the highest grade point average. They are expected to demonstrate the values and ideals of both the school inside and outside of the classroom. The class of 2020's valedictorian is Mr. Dalton Sherman.
Friends, family, faculty, and fellow graduates, good evening. My name is Dalton Sherman, and it is an honor to stand here as a valedictorian of the class of 2020. I would like to start with the many thank yous that are owed to those that have helped us reach this day. To the administration, thank you for keeping our class in line, even though we could be a handful at times. Your guidance throughout these last 4 years will forever shape each and every one of us as we proceed onto our individual journeys into adulthood. To the teachers and staff, thank you for understanding our class and coming to the quick realization that our class is different from most. You made sure each and every one of us is bound for success in the future. To the janitors, thank you for cleaning up after us when we failed to do so ourselves. From cleaning food from underneath the lunch tables to sweeping confetti off of the gym floor after we used confetti cannons at the homecoming pep rally, you guys had us covered. I would also like to thank our guidance counselor, Mrs. Doki. Speaking on behalf of the class, you made the search for a college and career path as simplistic as it comes. You made sure each and every one of us knew what to look for in a college, and you supported each and every one of our decisions. To our families, thank you for being there for more than just your own kid. You guys are the much-needed support group that always made us realize that we could do better and to never settle for just okay. To my mom and dad, thank you for being my number one supporters throughout everything during the last 17 years of my life. You have forever instilled in me that hard work and dedication leads to success. To the class of 2020, thank you for the many memories that we've all experienced throughout the last 12 years. I will forever remember many events that occurred within the last 4 years, such as Jacob and Tucker dressing up as girls for the homecoming pep rally, Clay dressing up as Larry and Tyson on Superhero Day, Caitlin transforming into Boo off of Monsters, Inc., and also standing next to Caitlin as the homecoming king and queen. The list goes on and on, but know that each and every one of you holds a special place in my heart and memories in my time at Griggsville-Perry. Although the ongoing situation has stolen the end of our high school careers, it will not steal our future. Each and every one of you are bound for success. I would now like to leave you with a quote. Be strong now, because things will get better. It might be stormy now, but it can't rain forever. Thank you.
Superintendent Holly and Board President Mr. Eric Koonsman and the Griggsville-Perry School Board, I verify that these students receiving diplomas tonight have successfully completed the requirements set forth by the Griggsville-Perry Board of Education in the state of Illinois. I present to you the Griggsville-Perry graduating class of 2020. Emily B. Brown. B is the definition of a hard worker. Going all the way back to middle school, she has had no unexcused absences, giving her perfect attendance. Not only does she shows up to work. B gives 100% in the classroom and always has a positive attitude. During her high school career, she has been a four-year member of the GP softball team, FFA member, a co-editor of the 2018-2019 GP yearbook, and a trusted senior office helper. Outside of school, B has been involved in traveling softball since 2012. B also is a very positive role model for her younger siblings. She always puts their needs before her own. B is truly a selfless person and puts others first. Her presence at GP will be missed. B plans to attend Blackburn College next year and major in biology while also playing softball. Good luck, B. Abby Rose Jones. I'm not sure there's a better word to describe Abby than sweet. Abby wears her heart on her sleeve and always puts others before herself. Family and friends are her number one priority. In addition, Abby takes school very seriously and always wants to do her best. She is the type of student every teacher loves to have in their class. Abby helps her peers in class, all while also giving 110% to her own work. This year, she has been a helper in the guidance office and always goes above and beyond her duties. Abby always asks what she can do to help and never complains. During her high school career, Abby has been a member of the volleyball team, softball team, and Acts of Random Kindness Club. Outside of school, Abby is employed by Walmart. After graduation, Abby plans to attend John Wood Community College and pursue a career in radiology tech. Congratulations, Abby. Ethan Dallas Miller. If you want to know who one of the hardest working students at GP is, look no farther than Dallas Miller. Dallas is meticulous when it comes to his academics, taking time to ensure his work is done is thorough and complete. He is not one to rush through things just to say that they are done. Dallas strives for perfection in anything he does. He is a quiet leader and always goes above and beyond the expectations asked of him. Dallas never asks for any praise or recognition, rather his humbleness is one of his best qualities. In addition, Dallas is very unique and talented. He is a gifted writer, loves acting and drama, and plans to pursue theater on the side in the future. During Dallas's high school career, he has been the vice president of the drama club. After graduation, Dallas plans on attending college at either WIU or UIS to become a teacher. Congratulations, Dallas. Maya Nicole Cattleman. Ever seen a smile that lights up a room? If not, you have never been around Maya. You would never be able to tell if Maya was having a bad day because she is always smiling and positive. Maya is an excellent role model for her younger siblings and can be seen holding her little brother's hand entering and leaving the school each day. In a way, she also holds the hands of her peers if they are going through a difficult time and reminds them to stay positive. She has a unique way of lifting up others, even during dark times. It is Maya's optimism and cheery personality that makes it almost impossible not to be happy around her. During her high school career, Maya has been a member and captain of the GP volleyball team and a member of the GP softball team. After graduation, Maya plans to attend John Wood Community College and then transfer to a four-year university to pursue a career in radiology. Congratulations, Maya. Sarah Morgan Hurst. Sarah is the epitome of what it means to be friendly. If you're standing in or walking through the halls of GP, you can count on being greeted with a big smile and a wave from Sarah. She cares about her family and friends more than she cares for herself. Sarah is always the first to volunteer to help someone in need. She is truly selfless. During her years at GP, Sarah has been a part of the Acts of Random Kindness Club, and outside of school, you can find her big smile ready to help you at the checkout at Walmart. After graduation, Sarah plans to attend college to pursue a career in psychology. Her caring personality and helpful nature will be a loss to GP, but a gain to those she works with in the future. Congratulations, Sarah. Ivy Olivia McCarter. Ivy has one of the biggest hearts. She looks out for her family and friends and always keeps their best interest in mind. Ivy would give the shirt off her back to anyone in need, whether it be a close friend or a complete stranger. She may be quiet, but when Ivy speaks, you'll want to listen. What she says is always thoughtful and meaningful. Ivy is a student that does not want any attention or recognition, but one that absolutely deserves it for the way she always puts others first and is a rock for many of her close friends and family members. When Ivy sets out to do something, there's no doubt that she will reach her goal. She is independent, kind, and honest. After graduation, Ivy plans to attend John Wood Community College and pursue a career as a paramedic. Congratulations, Ivy. Zachary Dawson Lee Mountain. When I think of a student I would trust to build or fix something, Zach comes to mind. He is a student that can tinker around on a little handmade gadget and turn broken pieces of this and that into a functioning machine. Watching Zach grow has been pretty humbling. He is a hard worker, loves his family, and has always been a great help to the staff. He is a very soft-spoken young man, but when you get to know him, he is pretty funny and knows how to sneak some one-liners in every now and then. Zach's work ethic will propel him as far as he ventures into life after high school. After graduation, Zach plans to stay in the workforce. Congratulations, Zach. Brooklyn Michelle Crone. Brooklyn's hard work and determination will get her far in life. She has been a GP cheerleader from 2018 to 2020, a member of the Science Club, Team Impact, and Adopt-A-Grandpal. She was also the co-editor of the 2018-2019 Tornado Times. In her free time, Brooklyn has made volunteering a priority, helping with community events such as the Griggsville Apple Fest and Peary Pioneer Days. Not only has she participated in the Queen pageant, but Brooklyn is a recipient of the Griggsville Apple Fest Queen Scholarship. Brooklyn is a great friend and role model, ensuring she is always there for the ones she cares about. Brooklyn has truly blossomed over her high school career in one that is known by many of her teachers as the most improved. Brooklyn is a motivated young woman who will never give up on her goals. After graduation, she plans to attend the University of Illinois at Springfield to pursue nursing. Brooklyn, congratulations. Clayton Edward Thomas. The Best Mullet Award in Pike County goes to Clay Thomas. His hair and his personality are both full of life. Clay's smile and laugh are both contagious. You can always count on him to make the most fun out of any situation. Under that big, goofy grin is a larger-than-life personality, and he is genuinely a kind soul. Clay sees the best in everyone and likes to see others succeed. As an office helper, Clay goes above and beyond to help the staff with whatever they need without complaint. No matter who you are, you can count on Clay to greet you in the hallway with a big smile. He is the kind of person that you are truly lucky to know. GP will miss his positivity and even his funny shenanigans. During his high school career, Clay has been a four-year member of FFA and is currently the vice president and has been a member of the GP basketball team. After graduation, Clay plans to attend John Wood Community College and major in business. Congratulations, Clay. Tyler Brenton DeJanes. There's a 100% chance that if you have been around Tyler, he has made you laugh. He always looks at the bright side of things and can cheer you up with his dry humor. He cares about his family and his friends with incomparable magnitude. Tyler is a leader inside and outside of the classroom. He always jumps up to offer help around the school, whether it be as an office helper or to simply use his muscles to move things around for the staff. Tyler is a member of the Pike County CEO program and has been involved in the Griggsville-Perry FFA for 4 years, 1 year as chapter treasurer and 1 year as chapter vice president. Outside of school, last summer, Tyler completed his basic training and is a member of the Illinois National Guard. We are proud of Tyler and his commitment to serving our country. Thank you for your service. Tucker Allen Koonsman. There's no other way to describe Tucker than dedicated. He is dedicated at school, always striving for success in his classes. Throughout his high school career, he has been a stellar student, never wavering from academic success, even though he is extremely involved at school. Dedicated is an understatement when it comes to sports. Tucker puts his heart and soul into sports and has been a leader on the GP basketball and baseball teams. He is always trying to find ways to improve his game and bring his all to his teams. There is no doubt that when Tucker puts his mind to something, he achieves it. Although Tucker might be put up a tough exterior, he is very caring, funny, kind, and truly wants the best for everyone. During high school, Tucker has been a four-year member of both the basketball and baseball teams. In addition, he is a National Honor Society member in the class of 2020 class president and a member of Team Impact. After graduation, Tucker plans to attend Spoon River College to pursue his business degree and play baseball. Then he plans to transfer to a four-year university. Congratulations, Tucker. Sage Allen Martin. When Sage is around, you're always going to have fun. He is kind, funny, and a very well-rounded person. He's the type of student who does not have a mean bone in his body and that you can't find a negative thing to say. Sage always has a smile on his face and treats everyone with the utmost respect. In addition, Sage is one of the most helpful students at GP, always lending a hand to anyone. He does this all with a smile. Sage is a very hard worker, both inside and outside of school. These qualities will take him far in life. It is not often you find a young person with such maturity and an impeccable character. During his high school career, Sage has been a four-year member of FFA and is currently the GP chapter president. Outside of school, Sage can be found working in construction. After graduation, Sage plans to attend Lincoln Land Community College to pursue a career as a lineman. Congratulations, Sage. Tyler William Thomas. Tyler Thomas is a bright, caring young man that has mounds of potential. Tyler is loyal to his friends and would offer them the shirt off his back. He is a great listener and acts as a counselor to many of his friends, always putting himself last. Tyler is the first person they go to if they are having a bad day or need advice. Tyler has the kind of smile that lights up a room and can instantly cheer someone up. If there were a special award for Tyler, it would be most times asked to remove his hood in the building. He always took it down with a smile, though. It has been amazing to watch Tyler grow up into a mature, responsible, caring young man. He has a very bright future ahead of him. During his high school career, Tyler has been a member of the GP basketball team, and after graduation, Tyler plans to join the Illinois National Guard. Congratulations, Tyler. Caitlin Brooke Lienertz. Caitlin is a true tornado. She is supportive of all of her peers' activities and can be seen in the stands of most Eagles and Tornadoes sporting events. Caitlin truly embodies what it means to have school pride, so much so that she was selected this year's homecoming queen. Not only is she supportive to her peers in the stands, Caitlin also is positive and uplifting inside and outside the school building. Her smile and laugh are contagious, and she truly has others' interests at heart. In addition, Caitlin has been an awesome office helper this year, assisting the staff with whatever they need with no complaints. During her high school career, Caitlin has been a four-year member of the GP volleyball and softball teams, a member of Acts of Random Kindness, Team Impact, and the Science Club. After graduation, Caitlin plans to attend Quincy University and study forensics. Congratulations, Caitlin. Dalton Jarrett Sherman. Dalton is a go-getter. He doesn't settle for anything less than his best. Dalton is highly motivated. When he puts his mind to something, there's no doubt he will achieve it. Ever since he was a freshman, Dalton has known what his goals are for after high school, and he has put all of his energy into working towards those goals, never giving up or giving less than 100%. Dalton is also very personable, kind, modest, and respectful to both students and staff. Dalton brings a very positive energy to GP, so much so that he was elected this year's homecoming king. Overall, Dalton is a very well-rounded and is a natural leader. During his high school career, Dalton has been a four-year member of the GP basketball team, a member of National Honor Society, Team Impact, Science Club, and Student Council. After graduation, Dalton plans to attend Bradley University and earn his doctorate of physical therapy degree. Congratulations, Dalton. Erin Michelle Resba. Erin has the kind of personality that can light up a room. You rarely see her without a smile and can cheer you up with her constant positivity and sense of humor. Erin is very artistic and creative. She can create videos for any occasion and even runs her own photography business. Erin is very optimistic and selfless, always putting others' needs before her own and even helping her classmates get through these uncertain times. In the classroom, Erin is hardworking and motivated. She is the first to come to aid her classmates and to her teachers. During her high school career, Erin has been a four-year member of the GP softball team, member of Acts of Random Kindness, yearbook editor, member of the Science Club, Team Impact, and Adopt a Grandpal. She is also a current class member of the Pike County CEO program. After graduation, Erin plans to attend Illinois College and double major in psychology and art. Congratulations, Erin. Jacob Reed Freeman. Honest, funny, polite, and respectful are all words that can be used to describe Jacob. He is the type of person who truly sees the best in everyone and treats others as he would want to be treated. Jacob has a positive outlook in all situations, which in turn spreads positivity and optimism throughout our school. In the fall, Jacob transferred to another local high school. We knew we would miss him, but we didn't realize how much his presence would be missed here at GP. Jacob returned to us in January, and we are so happy to have him back at GP. Jacob has been a four-year member, an essential part of the PGP football team, and is a current member of the Science Club. Outside of school, he is employed by Dot Foods, and after graduation, Jacob plans to attend Illinois College to pursue physical therapy, sports medicine, and to play football. Congratulations, Jacob. Jennifer Alexis Bingham. Throughout her high school career, Jennifer has been extremely involved. Jennifer is a four-year member of the GP Cheer Squad, president of Student Council, a member of Team Impact, Art Club, Science Club, Adopt a Grandpal, National Honor Society, and Pike CEO. Outside of school, Jennifer is a former Griggsville Apple Fest Queen and is a member of SNS School of Dance, 4-H, in the Methodist Church of Griggsville, where she has gone on 5 mission trips. After graduation, Jennifer plans to attend the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign to major in human development and family studies. Congratulations, Jennifer.